The first part of this I want to get into is not being needy. So most people are put at a disadvantage immediately if they see themselves as a salesperson. If you see yourself as a salesperson, you are pretty much brought up with the idea that the customer is always right. The customer can easily walk out at any time. You need this deal. You need to close this. You need to have a higher sales figure for the day so you don't get in trouble, so you don't get fired, so you can pay your rent. Whereas the customer doesn't need it, so they can go anywhere they want. And if you get yourself caught in this, you're immediately at a disadvantage. And the problem with this mindset, the problem with being needy, with feeling like I need to get this deal, I need to get this repair, I need to get this customer, is that when you are put at that disadvantage, you are more likely to think with your emotions. You're more likely to act on your emotions, I should say, because you're not going to be thinking when you act on emotions, and you're more likely to not use your brain. And whether you're dealing with vendors, whether you're dealing with board repairs, or whether you're dealing with customers, when you start thinking, I shouldn't say that. When you start using your emotions and, you know, acting based on your emotions instead of acting based on your thoughts and using your brain, you are fucked. You need to be using your brain at all times. And in order to have a blank slate where you can use your brain properly, you cannot be in a state where you are needy. And you can't give off to your customers that you are needy. So when you start giving away things for free, when you start compromising when you don't have to compromise, when you start saying, you know, usually this takes 40 minutes, but let me see what I can do to get it done in 20 minutes, you're putting yourself at this disadvantage. And honestly, people are not really that comfortable with people that are needy. Again, just let's look at something that has nothing to do with sales. Let's look at the dating world. If a guy is at a bar just sitting there reading his book, and he's not really, he looks up at you once, smiles, and goes back to his book and his drink, the woman is more likely to be interested in him than if he's like, "Hi, how are you? My name's Josh. I make this amount of money. I work for a successful firm. How are you? You want to go out with me tomorrow night?" It's creepy. It's just weird when people seem needy, like they need your attention. Well, again, an example of neediness. I was in Las Vegas recently, and as I explained in the Reballing is Bullshit video, two beautiful women walked up to me, and they're like, "Hi, how are you? What are you doing here? This, that, and the other." And they had this neediness about them, and it made me feel uncomfortable. And I was uncomfortable because something didn't seem right, and what didn't seem right is they wanted me to give them $50 to take a picture with them. We're conditioned to feel weird when there's neediness in a situation. So the first rule of any type of sales thing is that you don't need this deal. Again, you want to be attentive to the customer. You want to care about the customer. You want to be concerned that they are getting a high quality of service. You do not want to be needy. You do not want to be clingy. You do not want to be like the salesperson that follows you around, OMG, while you're picking out your t-shirts. "How can I help you? Is everything all right? Have you found everything? Do you want to try this shirt? Do you want to try that shirt? Have you tried this?" Like, just shut the fuck up and let me pick out my t-shirts. If you've walked into an OMG store in Manhattan, you know what I'm talking about. And that type of neediness is not going to do you any good in the real sales world. So when somebody comes in, I talk to them about their issue. I'm attentive. I make sure they understand that I'm listening to them. I ask questions to try to figure out everything that concerns them. I may be doing all this while I'm looking into a microscope and soldering, or while I'm measuring something on the oscilloscope, or while I'm writing something down. Again, I'm attentive to them, but I'm not needy. It's not like I need this deal. It's not like I'm hovering on them. I don't give a shit if you wind up getting something fixed here. Truly, I don't. I mean, if we are not the best for you, go somewhere else, go to where the better deal is, go to whoever is going to help you the best. I am not needy, because when you are needy, you stop using your brain, and when you stop using your brain, you enter shitty, shitty deals. You tell people that shit's going to be done before you can actually get it done. You tell people that you can get it done the day the part arrives, and the part arrives at 8 o'clock, and you close at 7:30 because you pee, and it sucks, and then you're fucked, and then you get a bad review, and blah, blah, blah. Being needy is bad. Avoid being needy. Do not be needy. You do not need this repair. You do not need this sale. You do not need this deal. Once you wipe yourself of that mindset, great things happen. And the same thing happens with repairs. The best repairs, the repairs where I learned something that I would have never learned otherwise, the repairs where I have truly felt like I am at the top of my field and I'm good at what I do, is when I said, "I give up. I'm never going to make this work." And I put it in the shelf and I put it in the fuck section. It's like, I give up. I'm going to tell them it's unfixable, and then they never come back to pick it up. And like 60 days later, I just look at that little pile of crap that I failed on. I don't need it to work, and I take it and I put it on the desk, and I realize that I was missing one stupid resistor that was just like staring me in the face, that's on sideways, and I fix it. But while I'm in that state of, I need to get this done in 45 minutes, they're bothering me, they have a plane to catch, this, that, and the other, I wind up missing this like little resistor that's on sideways because like the emotion takes over and I don't use my brain. Don't become needy. Keep yourself in a calm and relaxed state at all times by not being needy. You may be the salesperson. You may be somebody who needs to make a sale. You may be somebody that's minus $500 in their bank account and your $3,700 of rent is due tomorrow. I've been there many times, but I still don't need to make the sale.